Assalamu alaikum students, I hope you all are fine. Alhamdulillah, I am also fine. And this video is basically for the grade 8 students, and in this video we'll be solving the baseline test which was given to them a few days back. So we have a baseline test in front of us, and I have solved that test for you guys. I will just explain the solution in this video. The first question is, which number is the greatest perfect square between 4 and 50? So I have written all the perfect squares between 4 and 50. The next perfect square after 4 is 9, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, 5 square is 25, 6 square is 36, and 7 square is 49. And so the greatest perfect square between 4 and 50 is 49. So 49 will be our answer. The next question was, we have to find the square root of 196. The square root of 196 is 14. And 14 multiplied by 14 is 196. You can also calculate it by the division method, and you can calculate it by making pairs, but I will recommend you to at least learn the squares of first 20 numbers. It will help you guys in this paper 1, and you don't need to calculate it by the division method. If you are going to remember the first 20 squares, so it will be easier for you to solve these type of questions. The third one is, we have to circle the number which is divisible by 3, means the numbers which come in the table of 3. So 30 is the number which comes in the table of 3, 9 is the number, 33 is the 9, 36 is 18, and 15 is the number which are divisible by 3. So we have circled them. The next question is, we have to write brackets. We have to include the brackets in this calculation to make it correct. The calculation was very simple, 18 plus 7 divided by 3 plus 2. So we know that if we are making brackets like this, we have to check it. 18 plus 7 is 25, then divide, and then this bracket is 3 plus 2, 5, and 25 divided by 5 is 5. So our answer is 5, and these brackets are correct since they are giving us an answer of 5. So this is the brackets. You have to make more brackets like this. You can also check it by changing the bracket. If you are changing the bracket, if you are making a bracket over here, 7 divided by 3 will be in decimals and your answer will not be 5. So you can check it by hit and trial method. The next question is, evaluate. We have to evaluate this. We have to use the integer properties, the sign properties, and this is two negative signs, and there is a bracket in between. So minus and minus will be plus. Plus 129, this positive sign when multiplied by minus will be minus, and this will be minus 301 plus 12. Now what will I do? I will just add the plus. This is plus 129 and this is plus 12, so I will add these two numbers to get 141, and then this minus 119 and this minus 301 will add up to give me minus 420, and then I will subtract these two numbers to get my final answer, which is minus 279. And the next part is, I have to minus 3 and minus 3, you know that 2 minus adds, and sign belongs to the greater, so there will be the negative sign. Minus 3 minus 5 will be minus 8. Then there is a sign of multiplication in between. Minus 3 and minus 4 is minus 7. When I will multiply these two, minus and minus will become plus, and 8 times 7 is 56. So this was a very easy question. The next is, you have to write the missing numbers. 17.26 multiplied by 1000, and you guys know that when we multiply something with 1000, we have to shift the decimal to the right side. And how many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3. So we'll shift this decimal to the right side to the 3 digits. 2 are there, 1 is not there, so I have to include 0, and my final answer will be 17260. And say 3.8 divided by a number, we have to find that number, gives an answer of 0.38. so the decimal is moving on the left side, so how many there are, the decimal is over here and it has moved to two places over here, so I will add two zeros to one. So 3.8 divided by 100 will be equals to 0.038. so this was questions which you guys can expect in paper 1, and these are basically mental math type calculations, and in this part calculator is not allowed, so you have to do the calculations by your hand. The next page, moving on to the next page, we have The first question is we have to work out the first three and the tenth term of the following sequence, and general expression has been given to us, and we just have to put the value of n. For the first term we will put the value of n 1, and 5 multiplied by 1 will be 5, and for the second term we will put the value of n as 2, 5 multiplied by 2 will be 10, and for the third term we will put the value of n as 3, 5 multiplied by 3 is 15. And since we have to find the 10th term also, so we will put 10th in place of, for the 10 terms, 5 multiplied by 10 will be equals to 50. Moving on to the next part, is a general expression of 2n plus 8. So we will do the same thing, we will put the value of n equals to 1, 2 and 3 to get this. When we will put the value of n equals to 1, 2 multiplied by 1 is 2 and 2 plus 8 is 10. When we will put the value of n equals to 2 for the second term, we will get 2 plus 2 multiplied by 2 equals to 4, and 4 plus 8 will be equals to 12. And we have to find the third term as well, so we will put the value of n as 3, 3 2 is 6, 6 plus 8 is 14. And since we have to find the 10th term also, so we will put n equals to 10, 10 multiplied by 2 is 20, 20 plus 8 is 28. So this was the question about terms in sequence. In the next question, we have to work out an expression, and we know that in order to work out an expression, we have a simple formula, Tn is equals to a plus n minus 1d, and we will be using this formula. A is the first term, and since we have to find the general expression, n will be n, and d is the common difference between the second and the first term. So in this question we will be applying the formula directly. Our first term in this is 20, so I will put 20, then I will use a positive sign, and then n minus 1 will be same because I have to find the general term. And then d, the difference, 22 minus 20 is 2, 24 minus 22 is 2, 26 minus 24 is 2, so the difference is 2. So I will write 2 in place of d, and then I will multiply this 2 with n and minus 1. 20 will be as it is, positive sign as it is, 2 multiplied by n will be 2n, 2 multiplied by minus 1 will be minus 2, 20 minus 2 will be plus 18, and 2n as it is. So this is basically the general term for this expression. You can calculate any term by using this general expression of this sequence. Moving on to the part B, in part B we have minus 8, minus 4, 0, 4 and 8. Again we will be using the same formula. And if in this question our first term is a, the first term a is minus 8, so I have written minus 8, then a positive sign, n minus 1 will be as it is, and then the difference. The difference is the second term minus the first term. So this is the second term minus, and this is the first term. So minus minus will be positive, and my answer will be plus 4. So I have written plus 4, and I have applied the calculation. 4 multiplied by n will be 4n, 4 multiplied by minus 1 will be minus 4, this minus 4 and this minus 8 will be minus 12, and 4n will be as it is. So this is the expression for this for this sequence, and we have to work out an expression, so we have worked out the expression. So moving on to the next question, the next question is about the shading of Venn diagram. We have four parts. In this part, this is A intersection B, means we have to shade the common part. This is A, means we have to shade the A whole. This is basically B minus A whole complement. So first we will shade B minus A. B minus A means this part of B shaded only. B minus A means we have to shade this part only, and when there is a complement on the outside, means except this part, we have to shade all the other part. Complement means not this part, and the rest part will be shaded. So B minus A will be this part, and since we have to find B minus A whole complement, so we will leave this part and we will shade all the rest. And this is A complement union B complement. A complement means not A, we have to shade everything not A, so we have shaded everything not A. Then union means we have to shade the both, and B complement means not B other than B, so we will leave the B and shade everything. So we will get this type of diagram where we will be shading A complement union B complement. Complement means not, simple, just remember this thing. Complement means not, A complement means you don't have to shade A and you have to shade everything other than A. B complement means you don't have to shade B and you have to shade everything other than B. When you will do that, you will find a diagram shaded like this. So this was the question of Venn diagram, which was a bit tricky, And moving on to the next part, this is basically the next part. In the next part, we have some questions. We have to find A complement, B complement, C complement, and A union B complement, whole complement. So you guys know that for A complement, we use a formula union minus A, sorry, universal minus A. So this is our universal set. So I have just saw cancel out the common elements of universal and A to get this answer. The answer of A complement is EFGH. The answer of B complement, U minus B means universal minus B, just cancel out the common elements between the universal and B, and the remaining elements of the universal will be my answer, and my answer is BCFGH. C complement, again using the same formula, universal minus C, cancel out the common elements of universal and C, and then see what is remaining in the universal, and my answer is A, B, D, E. And then in the final part, we have to find A union B first. A union B means I have to combine these two elements in such a way that no one should be repeated, no one should be left out, and then I have to find their complement, means I have to subtract the answer from the universal. I will cancel out the common elements and my final answer will be F, G, and H. So the next question is about coordinate geometry, and I have been given with the equation. I have this equation. This equation is already arranged in the slope-intercept form, and I have to calculate the slope of the line. I know that when your equation is arranged in slope-intercept form, the coefficient of x gives you the slope. So the coefficient of x means the number with x is 3, so the gradient will be 3. The next part is a pattern, and I can see that I have to multiply these two numbers to get this number. So I will just multiply these two numbers to get my answer, which is equals to 4. Minus and minus will be plus, and 8 times 0.5 means half of 8 is 4. So 4 will be my answer. And we have a pie chart, and we have to answer some questions from the pie chart as well. The first question is, which is the least favorite food? The least favorite food is the sandwiches, so I have written sandwiches. Then the question is, what is the percentage of customers who like fried chicken? Since I have to find the percentage, so I will multiply it with 100, but first I have to make a fraction, and I can make a fraction by taking fried rice by taking the number of people who like fried chicken on the numerator and the total people in the denominator. The total people is 90, so 20 upon 90 multiplied by 100 will give me a percentage, and the percentage is 22.2%. What is the angle of sector for the hot dog? Again, I have to find the angle of sector, the hot dog, the people who like hot dog is 30. So again, since I have to find the angle of sector, I know that the total angle is 360, so I have to multiply it with 360, but first I have to make the fraction. So I will make the fraction by taking the number of people of hot dog and the number of total people, 30 upon 90, multiply by 360, and my answer will be 120 degrees. Line and angle properties, I know that these two angles, this is a cross, so these two angles are vertically opposite angles, so B will always be equals to 40, vertically opposite angle. And since I know that this C will be equals to A, because these two are also vertically opposite angles, and I know that this is a straight line, this is a straight line, so this total angle will be 180. So I know this is 40, so I will just subtract this from 180 to get C. So C will be 180 minus 40, because this is a straight line, and I can show you by marking, this is basically a straight line, this is a 180 angle total. So when I will subtract 180 and 40, I will get the value of C, which is equals to A. So moving on to the last page of our baseline test, we have a question related to area, perimeter, and we have a trapezium, and we have to find the perimeter. I know that perimeter is basically the sum of all the sides, so I just have to add all the sides. There are four sides of a trapezium. This is 17, this is 13, this is 17, and this is 29. So I will add these four to get my perimeter, which is equals to 76 centimeter. And the last question is about probability. I know that probability is basically a fraction whose denominator represents the total outcome and the numerator represents the possible outcome. So we have a spinner which has 5 sided, so the denominator will be 5, because the total outcome will be 5 every time, and I have to find the probability that the spinner lands on an odd number. So how many odd numbers are there? 1 and 2. There are 2 odd numbers, so there will be 2 upon 5. The probability of an odd number will be 2 upon 5, and how many even numbers? 2, 4 and 6, so 3 even numbers, so the probability will be 3 upon 5. So this was all about your baseline test. I hope many of you have solved it correctly. And if you still have any if you have still any confusion, you can tell your teachers, or you can tell me, so that we can discuss your confusions. And if you want to check your work, you can check it your work with the pencil, and you just have to mention self, you just sign yourself, you just signed it at the bottom and write the date. Thank you very much.